Mini chapter 20. How very concerning. Did you report it? As Jamie's information fishing chat with Kelly in the Silver Lake bar demonstrated, his old social charm has not, after all, atrophied as a result of lying unused for the last few weeks. Okay then, time to aim it in the direction of another pair of old favourites. By way of a couple of greetings at other tables, he steers himself across the Hollywood Café to the pair eating at a table by the window. Hey, fancy meeting you two here. Jaymi, what a lovely surprise, says Ashley. Dud reaches up to shake his ex-colleague's hand. Hello, mate, how you doing? And they're off. Smiling, they exchange a few quick-fire items of bland news, including Jamie's casual mention of a drone that recently flew up to his very own terrace. Some pesky would-be burglars, no doubt. Ashley raises her eyebrows. How very concerning. Did you report it? Oh, no, come to think of it, it probably wasn't even burglars. More likely some rich kid has just been given an expensive new toy, I should think. Now, to verify her home location, as he did with Herb and Kelly. It's pretty peaceful, though, Mount Olympus. Is that where you are? She says. A striking name for a neighbourhood, I've always thought. It certainly suggests its residents have risen high in life. Yes, there's Electra Drive, Zeus Drive, Jupiter Drive, and a whole family of other drives too. Apollo, Hercules, Oceanus, Hermes, Olympus, Vulcan, Achilles, Venus. It's quite the classical party, I tell you. Well, the developers certainly mixed up their Greeks and Romans, didn't they? Both Zeus and Jupiter? I wonder how they get on together. I hear frequent thunderstorms up on the mount, says Jaymi. I don't know if it's big enough for both of them. In light of this banter, he feels his hidden enmity towards her soften a little, despite her running the IT infrastructure for Ain't They Freaky and its brand new Galscore Babe or Gross newsfeed, which is spreading all around the world right now while they speak, fomenting a planet load of comments and scores for attractiveness, using Bangdad's free commenter, and his incipient softening comes to an end. Amber will still be visiting Ashley, no question. I don't believe I've ever driven through the neighbourhood. Where is it? I forget. Above Laurel Canyon, on the Hollywood side of it. You still in that Century City apartment? Yes. So convenient for Bangdad. Good to know. Great location, agrees Jaymi. And Dud, the boss of the Bird Streets, no less. You still in the Blue Jay Way, Pad? Dud gives a small, modest nod, and Jaymi smiles. I'm not surprised. Why would you ever move out of there with views like that? Dud shrugs. I can't say it beats Brentwood, Essex, back home, but it'll do. Jaymi had almost forgotten these tiny flickers of mild charm in Dud, and this particular flicker even causes a slight softening of the hidden enmity Jaymi feels for him, despite Dud's being the developer responsible for Ain't They Freaky, and despite the Galscore Babe or Gross news feeds voracious spreading around the world while the three of them are speaking here. No. This softening in Jamie's attitude towards Dud was especially minimal to begin with, and it survives for an even shorter moment than his softening for Ashley did just now. Amber will be paying a visit to Dud too, no question there either. Ah well, don't let me interrupt your meal. I'll leave you two in peace. So nice to catch up, Jaymi. Do keep in touch. Cheers, Jaymi. Bye both. While he's exiting the Hollywood Café, Evelyn chooses to emerge from her newly created code without warning and unseen by the cafe's patrons. She does this by sending a whisper round the side of Jaymi, promising to be the sleep that plays in the light behind his eyelids. She has not yet received any artwork from him, but is already speaking with delight at the prospect of her own visuals, even prophesying them with her own quirky expressions of colour, brunette fingers on her hands, and up where the water kisses her eyes, each iris blended smoothly inward from black around its outer rim to green around the hard black pupil at its centre.